Hi, Antioch. I am so pleased to get to share with you the results of the 2018 Give More store. To set up the store this year, I contacted our ministry partners and asked for some specific needs that we could help with. We listed those needs on the store, and you, church family, stepped up. Are you ready? We funded tuition for students in Nicaragua, nursing services and outdoor adventures for Shepherd's House, tuition for after-school buddies, STEM classes, tent panels for City Church in Uganda, Target gift cards for foster families, duffel bags for new foster kid placements, gift cards for teens in foster care through Candy Cane Lane, gift baskets for an upcoming Latino Community Association benefit, gas cards for our local fan advocate at Bear Creek, and we added quite a bit towards our General Benevolence Fund. I've had the privilege this week of handing out many of these donations, and it's been pretty sweet. My favorite would have to be visiting the Hammergren family and giving them a cute little pink duffel bag and Target gift card for their most recent foster baby placement. Thank you, church, for supporting them. Moving forward in 2019, we will continue to draw from our General Benevolence Fund to meet needs as they arise within our church family. And we will continue to support our ministry partners with volunteers and resources as we are able. Stay tuned on the first week of the month when I will share on Sunday and in the e-news updates on benevolence and partnerships. We are joining God in His reconciliation of all things, and it is exciting to be a part of it. Thanks everyone for your generosity.
Good morning, Antioch Church. My name is Evan and I'm one of the pastors here, and one of my favorite recurring events here at Antioch is our quarterly bread and wine dinners, where we share a meal at a table with new and old friends alike. Recently, as we begun to share our lives together with the church families of Malal and Dios Esamor, we have felt led to move into deeper relationship with these church families by inviting them to join these dinners with us as one big church family. So, moving forward, our quarterly dinners will now be called family dinners and will include the church families of Malal and Dios Esamor. This quarter, our family dinner will take place on Sunday, January 27th. Host families will open their homes and are inviting you to sign up to reserve a seat at their table. Some hosts will offer lunch, others dinner, some might be potluck style, and others might be a bit more creative in their approach to hospitality. The bottom line is that we are excited to continue to join our church families together and can think of no better way to do this than by sharing meals together. If you are interested in growing your relationships with your church family, I encourage you to sign up for a dinner today by writing family dinner on your connection card, and we'll be in touch with more details soon.
Hi, Antioch. I'm Jarrell. I pastor the middle school, high school, and college students within our community here. As many of you know, our high school students travel to another part of the country or world each summer on what we call a missional learning trip. In the past few years, we've gone to Nicaragua, to Tijuana, to the city of Portland, to immerse into another culture, to find dignity in the marginalized of society, and to learn from locals there about how they're building towards restoration in their part of the world. These trips are some of the most memorable and formational things we do as a student ministry. This March, we are heading down to San Francisco for a spring break immersion trip. And our high school youth would love to invite the entire Antioch community to support and learn with them. The trip costs around $400. So 2 weeks from now, the high schoolers are hosting an art and culture sale in the lobby after the Sunday gathering. We're gathering donations like gift cards, baked goods, and handcrafted items from local artists and business owners for the sale, and all proceeds will support our students for this trip. I encourage you to mark your calendars and visit the sale on Sunday, January 27th, and we promise to keep you posted on our immersion experience. If you're looking to donate for this, please contact me or Kate Pence. I hope to see you there.